Hey guys! In this video, we're going to get started with Rust. This video is going to be the first video of the series going in depth with Rust. Unfortunately, due to Rust complexity, I wouldn't recommend this programming language to anyone completely new to programming. So, this tutorial assumes you already know a bit of coding.
Hey, Aurora from the future here. Let's see what I meant by basic knowledge of one programming language. So this can be simple programming languages like Python or JavaScript. A lot of tutorials now assume that you know at least some C or C++ prior to diving into it. Rust is a relatively new programming language and it doesn't have a lot of resources. However, when creating this tutorial, I tried to make it as beginner-friendly as possible, so you don't need to know these languages. However, you will need some basic knowledge of a versions control system like Git, how to use the terminal, and how to use Visual Studio Code. Now back to me.
Okay, so if you want to learn a bit more about Rust, sit back, get your computers ready, and let's go. Hi, my name is Aurora, and on this channel, I make videos to help you grow as a developer. So be sure to hit the subscribe button below and turn on the bell notification icon so you don't miss a thing.
In this video, we're going to cover what is Rust, we're going to compare Rust to C++, we're gonna talk where we can use it, how to install it, what is cargo, and by the end, you should be able to run your first program. So this tutorial takes all its resources from the book The Rust Programming Language and is available for free. Link is down in the description. By the way, this video is sponsored by Kodadot. They're an NFT marketplace on Polkadot, so if you're into crypto, go check them out. Okay, let's get into Rust. Rust is a relatively new programming language, and it's great when we want speed. So what do we mean by that? When we want your programs to run fast. It's an upgrade to programming languages like C and C++, and it allows for low-level control, like controlling memory usage without all the hassle traditionally associated with such control. It's also great when we want stability. What do you mean by that? Well, we can mitigate a lot of runtime errors simply by using the compiler. In Rust, the compiler plays a gatekeeper role by refusing to compile code with bugs that are hard to find. Some of these bugs are prevented because of the inherent design of the program. For example, Rust doesn't have a null pointer, but we will get into that in the future. Okay, let's get into comparing C++ and Rust. At first glance, we can see more points for C++. It's understandable since it's a language that has been around since the 80s. It has a larger community of developers, therefore also more frameworks and libraries are written for it. But this can all change in the future. Programs can now be written faster in Rust because of the semantics and the compiler. Rust has also more vigorous code checks than C++, therefore allowing you to write better code. However, be prepared to wait for some time with the compiler. When it comes to development cost, both C++ and Rust developers are hard to find. Rust is a relatively new language with less developers, thus they are a bit more expensive. But that's good for you learning this course. Okay, where can we use Rust? So, Rust can be used both by companies and individuals. And it's great when you want low-level processing, so command line tools, embedded devices, DevOps tooling, or IoT applications. When we want fast processing, so like machine learning, web services, search engine, and actually even major parts of the Firefox web browser were written in Rust. And stability, so blockchain development. So let's proceed with the installation process. So for installing on Linux and Mac, just type install Rust, and then you should come to a website like this. So copy this command for the terminal and open up your terminal. Just paste this command and run. So now we say, okay, proceed with the installation. Now if we go to another tab and type Rust Rust C -- version, we can see the Rust is installed. So with this you will also need a linker, which is a program that Rust uses to join its compiled outputs into one file. However, you probably have one. If you get any linker errors, you should install a C compiler, which will typically include a linker. To install it, just type Xcode select --install. I won't install it because I already have it. For installing on Windows, the process is a bit different. Here you can click on See other installation methods and scroll down till you see on Windows download and run rustup.ini.exe. And the best resources that you can follow afterwards is on the Rust book. So if you click on the Rust programming language on the installation page, you can see here there is the installation process for Linux and Macs, and here is the installation for Rustup on Windows. I think this is the best way that you can install it on Windows. Here, one of the requirements is to install Visual Studio, and when doing troubleshooting, you can use this command on PowerShell. Okay, let's create our first program. In the terminal, let's create a source directory called learn-rust. This will be also on GitHub, so you can check in the description below. And let's go into it and create a new directory inside of it called hello world. Okay, so let's open it up and create a new file inside of it called main.rs. .rs is an extension we can use in Rust. Yes, I trust the authors. And if we open up this file, we can create our first program in it. So to create our first program, let's type fn. This indicates a function. So the main is actually the first piece of code that runs in every file. And the curly braces indicate a function body. So now let's type println and type inside of it hello world. And let's not forget the semicolon. So println is a macro, and if you don't understand what it is, don't worry. Essentially, what you have to know now is that macros are a way of writing code that writes other code. We will cover them in the future. So now if we go back to our terminal and type rustc main.rs, we can see our file has compiled. If we type ls-l, we can see there's a new executable file over here. Now let's run it to see what is the output. Hello world, amazing. Now we have created your first program. If we look into what kind of terminal programs are used when installing Rust, we can see we used Rustup. This is an installer for Rust, and then RustC, which is a compiler for Rust. So if we run the command rustup -- version, as we did before, we can see what kind of versions we have. Here you can see that rustup is 1.25. This will depend on when you installed it. And here we can see that rustc is in a different version. It is 1.67. With rustup, we can do also rustup update, and this will update some stuff. Here we can also change between different versions of Rust. With RustC, we can compile individual programs, but we usually don't do that. When using larger programs, we use Cargo, which is a package manager and a build tool for Rust. You might be asking yourself, okay, what is a package manager? A package manager is basically a tool that automates process of updating, installing, and overall managing dependencies. If you used, for example, TypeScript or JavaScript, that can be npm, pnpm, or something like that. And a build tool essentially means that it automates the creation of executable applications from source code. Let's try to use it. So by typing cargo new and create application called hello cargo, great, it created a binary. Let's go into it. Hello cargo. And now if we type ls-l, we see that some stuff have been created. Now, let's see this in Visual Studio Code. Here we can see that also Git was initialized with this, so that's great because we can use it when we want some version control stuff. And a cargo.toml file. TOML is basically a TOM obvious minimal language format, and this is cargo's configuration format. The package here stands for statements that configure a package, and the dependencies will be all the project dependencies that come in here. If we now go into source directory and look at the file main.rs, we'll see the command as previously written. Okay, now let's start the program. I'm going to do this by simply using the terminal in Visual Studio Code. You can do this by typing command J. Let's first compile all the programs. So we can do that by typing cargo build. This compiles all our files. So here we can see there has been created a new directory called target. And if we go into the directory debug, we can see hello cargo. This is an executable file and Visual Studio Code cannot essentially read it, but we can try to run it. So if we run it by typing target debug hello cargo, hello world runs. Amazing. Okay, to do both compilation and running the executable in a very simple way, let's do it by essentially running cargo run. Bam. You see, here all the things have been compiled and our program has run hello world. Amazing. Another file that has been created is cargo log. Cargo log basically keeps track of all exact versions of dependencies in our project. And if we type cargo check, we can see if our program actually compiles. This is great when we want to check if our program compiles without actually waiting all the time that it needs to compile all our files. Now the process is quite fast, but in the future when we'll have a lot of dependencies, this process will be quite time consuming. Let's sum up what we learned today. So today we learned that we can use Rust for when we want stability and speed. And it's great for when we want to write low-level code. It's an improvement on C and C++, since it doesn't require garbage collection and it has a system for preventing undesired behavior. We learned about RustUp, which is a command line tool for managing the version of Rust on your machine. We learned that Rust is ahead of time compile language, which means program have to be first compiled to an executable and then run. We learned how to use cargo, which is Rust package manager and build tool. We also learned how to run a hello world program. So next up, we'll create a guessing game and learn a few basic concepts about Rust.